a visit to RAF Cosford. That's the main entrance and restaurant, which, as you can see, made to look like a biplane, apparently. It does, it looks like a biplane. Kind of. Unusual start to the day. That's the Nimrod, which is based on the old Comet. Only just gone out of service 2 years ago. Looping the loop and defying the ground. They're all rightfully keen, those magnificent men in their flying machines. They can fly upside down with their feet in the air. They don't think of danger, they really don't care. Newton would think he had made a mistake to see those young men and the chances they take. Fairy Delta. Research aircraft, mainly researching here. The Bristol 188, or Flying Pencil as it was known. Give you some idea. TRS-2 would have been a world beater if they had the courage to carry on and put it into production. Some people say it may even still be flying now, it's that advanced. That probably needs updating. Engines developed here, later used in Concorde. Tornado. Swing wing, so it can go fast or it can go slow. Jaguar. By wire, they all do it now. That's a better look at the flying pencil. Air brakes. Very, very early Lightning development. Never complete without a Spitfire. Spitfire foreground, Hurricane background, thicker winged Hurricane, and the Mustang. One-way ticket airlines. Powered with a copy of the Rolls-Royce Merlin. The Hurricane and the Mustang side by side. Catalina flying boat. Catalina amphibious, so it can land on water or on land.
which we use for RAF rescue purposes in the main. Hawker Hind, last biplane to be used by the RAF. Smith 410, general purpose, fighter and bomber. Daimler engines. With the bonnet open. Japanese Kawasaki. Brought back after the Falklands conflict. That was brought back from the Falklands. When the gearbox went wrong, Mercedes wouldn't supply parts because it hadn't been paid for by the Argentinians. Wooden Wonder, Mosquito. Guy Gibson, who led the Dambusters raid, unfortunately died in one of these on active service. And that's the Avro Lincoln, which was based on the Avro Lancaster, of course. You can see the parentage in it quite easily. Griffin engine based on the Merlin. Looks like a bit of a mechanic's nightmare. Folland Nat here, used by the Red Arrows for quite a while, standing in front of the Lincoln. Very distinctive tail on the Lincoln. You can see its parentage back to Lancaster and that. No missing the number either. No museum's complete without a Harrier. Probably as lethal to the pilot as anybody else, I would think. And here, even the building is historic. A wartime hangar. Huge wheels take the weight. That's new. Modern. While these are original, war and pre-war. There's the beam to take the, or to guide the doors. Thanks for parking the pickup right in front of the name for the Dorner. This is the one that came up off the North Sea. Feel the heat coming out of there, can't you? Christ.
I'm ignoring that because nobody's supposed to be parking up there yet.
Condensation everywhere because it's so hot in there. Trying to keep it humid, stop it deteriorating, I guess. actually better than I thought it would be. Victor, part of the V-Bomber force. That's the Valiant. Very futuristic looking. Looks superb even now. Huge, great flipping thing. The Victor was adapted for refueling. Valiant behind it. Back to the Victor. Which leaves you with the Vulcan to make up the trio of the V-bombers. Very difficult to portray the size of this thing. Look, camera. Huge. Half an hour's reading on the side of this thing. You'll all be fried by the time you'd work that out.
There's another bit downstairs, Henry.
Russian made MiG. From the Korean War. Very simple, very rugged, very fast, very effective. Not built for comfort. General Dynamics F111. Followed the Jaguar with its swing wing technology. We come up with the idea, they all make it work. Maybe the fully flying tailplane. Tailplane of the Victor. Canberra bomber in the roof. Royal Navy Buccaneer front end. Again, they reckon these things could still be effective today. Mainly the engines are out of these things. Basically because they can still be reused long after the airframe's finished. Plus they drip oil all over the place. Even the structure of the building's quite interesting in here. I'm still trying to find an angle to give some idea of the size of this flipping thing. Distinctive Victor tailplane. Orca Hunter up in the roof. Lost a Javelin. It's just possible I saw that taking off from Gloucester. Many moons ago. superb aircraft. An English Electric Lightning hanging from the ceiling. Such a beast. And this lot is next. A Dakota on the top, above a York. The Hastings transport plane beneath that. Hastings. And a DC-3 Dakota. York transport plane. Oh, you had Lancaster wings on it. It's used in the Berlin airlift. This one actually spent quite a bit of time at Staverton, Gloucester. Before it came here. It's in a sorry state. Lunch shop. Not quite sure what that's doing here. Very simple undercarriage. Something of a montage. Few more green jobs. The Hastings. Bit more of a substantial undercarriage. Good shot of the Lightning. Meanwhile, the Javelin again. Didn't even know they did that. The so-called Jesus bolt is in there. There's somewhere, there's one bolt. Holds the whole thing together. That gives up. All right, you're out of there. Not to be trifled with then. Gatling gun. And this flipping great thing is a short Belfast. Oily bits. Oh, good. From that, one of the first, very crude, to that. Oily bits. Supercharger on the back in green. Huge, great engine. Daimler engine. Job to see how you get that off the ground. I think you'd have a job to get the engine off the ground, let alone the payload. Well, evidently they did. And noisy oily bits. Very noisy. That's what the jet engine started looking like. And that's out of a jumbo. Used to power a Concorde. Plumbing nightmare. Fallen nut used by the Red Arrows. A Bulldog. A Varsity. At the very back of Beverly. That's a very rare beast. It's a comet. It's what took us into the jet age. And this beastie, the Varsity Trainer. You wouldn't want those doors popping out in flight. Stop you a bit quick. Good for access though. Cooper Provost, RAF training aircraft. Beverly. Tailplane of the Beverly. Transport aircraft. Avro Anson. I flew in one of those. I had to turn back because it got a little bit bumpy in a thunderstorm. One of the few aircraft they didn't ask me to fly for them. They usually do if I end up in an airplane. Just ask the family. And a few nasty bits. The one in the background, the black and white. And a so-called doodle bug here. We could tip those out of the skies. Couldn't do much about those though. Would have been a war winner if it had come out earlier. All looks exceedingly crude by modern standards. Did the job though. As did that. Chipmunk flew in one of those. Corrugated tin aeroplane. For strength, of course. It's a Junkers 52 triplane. Tri-engined, anyway. And the car is built to last. Hercules.